Jeff.
Hey, Soraya, how's it going?
All right. You ready for another episode?
I am. And you know why I'm especially excited for this one? Because I miss going to concerts so much.
Oh my gosh, don't even talk about it. It's going to make me sad.
I know, I miss the live experience.
So what better, I mean, if we can't go to a show, maybe we can listen to a live show.
Yeah, that sounds good. And we were hacked a couple weeks ago from some bootleggers trying to stick in some bootleg episode. But we're going to talk about legitimate released live material from the Paisley Underground.
Yes, kids, only buy official releases. Whatever, don't worry about what Beth and Jane told you.
Yeah.
So let's get started.
Let's do it.
Hi, this is Soraya.
And this is Jeff.
Our podcast is called Paisley Stage Raspberry and Rhyme.
A podcast where the two of us play music that we like and share anecdotes and background about the tunes.
We hope you'll join our conversation. And without further ado, a grubiar.
Let's get groovy. All right, so today we are talking about legitimately released live recordings from the Paisley Underground. Officially released recordings.
There we go. Yeah. And we're specifically targeting the four seminal bands of the Paisley Underground. Dream Syndicate, Rain Parade, 3 o'clock, and the Bangles.
Sounds good. Yeah. I was thinking we could start with Rain Parade.
Ooh. All right, Jeff. Share. So first of all, what album did you pick and what's the song?
All right. Well, I picked a song from the Beyond the Sunset live album. It's also known as Behind the Sunset Live in Japan. I've got three, we talked about it before. I got three different versions of this album. And it's a great sounding live recording. And I believe it's the first live recording that the band released. It was recorded in Shibuya Hall. Is that how you say it? Shibuya?
Shibuya.
In Tokyo. The performance took place on December 16th, 1984. And we're going to move into this episode real slow-like. So we're not going to jump off with a fast-paced dance number from Rain Parade. It's not going to be the EDM Rain Parade.
No. We want you to savor the music.
Yeah, so my song is a slow-paced song. It's a song written by Matt Piucci. And the recording is phenomenal. And it's the song called Eyes Closed. And it wasn't released in a studio recording that I'm aware of. So this live recording is all we get. And it's primarily, I believe, Matt and Will Glenn with acoustic guitar, vocals, and violin. But I just think it's a beautiful song. And it's a shame it never got a studio release. So it's great that we have this live recording. So what do you say we listen to it?
Yes.
All right. So this is Rain Parade, Eyes Closed from Beyond the Sunset.
What are the words I used to describe? Could just die when I look close and into your eyes. I feel my soul into inside. Don't wanna know. So you're gone. Know that I cried. But that don't mean nothing. This thing won't die. I don't wanna know what everyone knows. They can't see what I see.
I just think that's beautiful.
It is.
Yeah.
It's a gorgeous song. And I mean, you and I have talked a lot about Matt Pucci's songwriting and his ability to arrange a song in a really beautiful manner. And this is a really lovely song.
It really is.
What a shame that we haven't seen it on other releases, but it's on this live one. And I don't know, it's a hearty song.
Yeah, it's a good performance, and for being a live recording, it sounds great, as does the rest of the album. So it must be a board recording. I'm sure it was professionally done.
And I think
before we move on to yours, I just wanted to go through the listing of that album real quick, if that's
please. Okay.
So of course I have it on vinyl, so there's two sides. Side one is Nightshade, which we've played on our podcast before, another song that never made it to an album. Prisoners, This Can't Be Today, Blue, Eyes Closed, that we just played, Ain't That Nothing, and you flip it over to side two, Don't Feel Bad, An Hour and a Half Ago, or one and a half hours ago, No Easy Way Down, and then they end with a cover, Cheap Wine, that includes Steve Wynn and Dennis Duck from the Dream Syndicate, and then also Dan Stewart from Green on Red. So that makes up that album, again, Beyond the Sunset, also known as Behind the Sunset Live in Japan.
How readily available is that album? Because I know you have three copies.
Yeah. So three different versions. I've seen it quite a bit, like on eBay and Discogs. It's out of print.
Right.
I think it's fairly easy to find.
It's worth it. And that cover at the end is pretty epic.
Yeah.
Speaking of covers, so one of the things, Jeff, that I like about live shows when I go see bands is, of course, you know, you and I have seen a number of shows together, and you know, you sing along to all the songs that you know. But what I like in live shows is seeing what little piece of treasure a band is going to throw my way in terms of a cover. Or even, you know, when they bust out, hey, this is something that, you know, we're working on. I love hearing those things because it gives me a better idea of this band and the things that they're enjoying or the things they're thinking about at the moment. And what I picked was, I picked a track from a different official live recording for Rain Parade, which is called Perfume River, released in 2002. And there is a CD version and an album version, but the song I picked happens to be a cover, and it's a television cover,
yes,
which is a song that I really like anyways, and it's called Ain't That Nothing. I'll talk about the album when we're done, but let's listen to it.
Says things are all over the
Awesome.
Isn't that great?
It is great.
So I got to just share a little piece of data that I found. So I found, because I wanted to know whether these this album in particular was available for streaming or download. And I haven't, you know, I'm hoping someone can correct me, but I haven't found it yet. So someone said, first off, this is a soundboard recording pressed in a limited run of 1,000.
Hmm.
So how available is that album?
Yeah, I don't know. It's a good question.
How many copies do you have?
I just have one.
If there are only 1,000.
I just have one CD of this.
Okay. So so I just thought that was interesting because I'm thinking 1,000. I mean, this was released on Rainfall Records in the UK. So maybe that speaks to that limited run. But just to backtrack and do what Jeff did. So the track list on this is, it starts off with Kaleidoscope, This Can't Be Today, Prisoners, Crashing Dream, Blue, You Are My Friend, Sad Eyes Kill, No Easy Way Down, Broken Horse, Ain't That Nothing, What She's Done to Your Mind, Saturday's Asylum, Like a Hurricane, and What Goes On. So there are some really good songs on this. And then if I think about it, if this is a soundboard recording, it's pretty good.
Yes. Yeah. Sounds great.
Yeah. And sounds amazing. And I like that version. I like this cover that they did.
That's good. And it's funny, it was released in 2002, but it was recorded in 1984. Actually,
right.
November 14th, 1984. At Scorgie's in Rochester, New York. I wonder if Pat Thomas was there.
We'll have to ask.
I bet he was.
We'll have to ask. But then, you know, that just kind of shows you and I are kind of in sync in terms of the timeline. We're relatively in the same period.
Yeah. So. And I wanted to tell you, Soraya, that was actually my first pick, Ain't That Nothing? And at the last minute, I ended up switching. And then I found out that you picked it. I was like,
I'm telling you, you and I share, you know, the one neuron that we've got in between us.
Yes. And then, so before we move away from Rain Parade, there's one other officially released album, or CD rather, San Francisco 2012, which I don't have yet.
Yet.
San Francisco, December 2012, Club du Nord. And that was a reunited band, Rain Parade. Right. Real quick track listing. You Are My Friend, Prisoners, Blue, Broken Horse, 1 hour and a half ago, This Can't Be Today, What She's Done to Your Mind, Depending on You, Kaleidoscope, and No Easy Way Down. So
beautiful.
I have that on my wish list, on my very short wish list up at the top. So probably by time we have our next podcast, I may have that. All right.
Let me know, because now I want it too.
Yeah.
You know that I have to copy you in many ways.
Yeah. I saw a couple copies online. One was 50, one was 350. Yeah, so, and I'm a cheapie, so. Okay, let's talk Dream Syndicate. What do you think?
Sounds good.
All right.
All right, so how many official live recordings are there?
I could find four. There were four that I found, and the first one was This Is Not the New Dream Syndicate album live, which we've talked about before. And a friend of mine actually bought a copy of that and gave that to me. So that was pretty cool. That one was a recording from the venue, the Aragon in Chicago, Illinois, recorded July 7th, 1984, as part of a radio station event, the WXRT 93.1 FM, Chicago, Illinois. So that's a fun recording. That album's pretty fun. On that, there's Tell Me When It's Over, Bullet With My Name On It, Armed With An Empty Gun, The Medicine Show, John Coltrane Stereo Blues, almost 10-minute version of that on this recording. And that was released around the time of Medicine Show. And then Live at Raji's was another one that came out, and that came out in 1989 on Enigma Records. Do you have the track listing for that one?
Yeah, I do. Live at Raji's. Here we've got a side A, B, C, and D. So side A, track list is Still Holding On to You, Four is For the Trees, Until Lately, That's What You Always Say, Flip It Over, Burn, Merrittville, and The Days of Wine and Roses. Then on the second LP, you've got The Medicine Show, Halloween, then Boston, and then side D is John Coltrane's Stereo Blues, an 11-minute, 44-second version.
It takes up the whole side.
Hey, man, it's good listening.
Yes. And that comes to the next live recording, which was released in Germany on Normal, or Normal, as Pat Thomas said when we talked to him. And it was released in 1993. And I'm going to play the song, then we'll talk about where it's from.
Sounds good.
But this is a version of When You Smile that is very interesting, I think. It's a lot different than what we heard from the Days of Wine and Roses days, and a lot different than what we hear now from this version of the band.
Right.
So this was, it's a more rock sounding version. So listen to this. This is the Dream Syndicate live doing When You Smile.
Look, scream for a second. Just get out. Scream really loud for a second. Okay, we're gonna run a loop of that thing and just like play through the whole thing. Sample.
Well,
So that's quite different than the earlier versions and what we get now. So it's a little bit more of a rock arrangement.
Yeah. I like that, you know, kind of slow move and then boom.
Yeah, yeah, it's good. So a little bit about where this comes from. It's from the album 3 1/2, The Lost Tapes, 1985 through 1988. And that song, of course, was originally from the debut EP and the first full-length album, The Days of Wine and Roses. So that song, When You Smile, was included on both. And the lineup on this show was Steve Winn, Dennis Duck, Mark Walton, and Paul B. Cutler was the guitar player. He also played with 45 Grave, and he played on the albums Out of the Gray and Ghost Stories from the Dream Syndicate. I don't know. I thought it was cool to have that different version of it. Real quick, the track listing from 3 1/2, The Lost Tapes, 85 through 88. Side one, Here on Earth as Well, I Ain't Living Long Like This, which is a cover. Healing Time, Lucky, a song written by all four of these members at this period of the band. Weathered and Torn, side two is The Best Years of My Life, Running from the Memory, When You Smile, It Hits You Again, and they end with Blood Money. So that was from 3 1/2, The Lost Tapes.
Pretty cool. Well, my pick is from a different live recording, and it's from the day before Wine and Roses, released on Bang Records in Spain from 2013. Now, this was another 2-LP collection, and the song I picked, surprise, surprise, is another cover. This is a Neil Young cover, and this is a favorite song of mine. It's a song I like a lot, and it's Mr. Soul.
Yes.
And let's talk about it. We'll talk about the album after we're done listening to Dream Syndicate cover Mr. Soul.
Mr. Soul, I just stopped by to pick a marine.
Isaac. We're sideshow act. That's loud. What do you say?
He says they're a sideshow act.
I know. this is a really good live recording, and I mean, always with Dream Syndicate, same as Rain Parade, when they play live, you get to see them really just improvise and kind of go off in different directions. It's fun. And this is I really enjoy this cover a lot.
Yeah.
So again, as I mentioned, this is a 2 LP live album. So starts off with side A, Some Kind of Itch. And then the second song is Mr. Soul. Flip it over. And each side is dedicated to one person. So side A is Steve Wynn. Side B is Kendra Smith. And that track listing is Sure Thing, That's What You Always Say, and Outlaw Blues. And then on the second disc, side C is Carl Pakoda. And that the two tracks on that is Open Hour and When You Smile. And then the side D is Dennis Duck. And that's Season of the Witch, which is a great cover too. And I really struggled between those two. And ends with The Days of Wine and Roses.
Yeah, I struggle with that too. I almost picked that as well.
Right?
Yeah, it's really good.
Just interesting for those of you listening, in case you don't have this album or the live one, what I was able to find is that on iTunes, there is a digital version of Live at Raji's and Day Before Wine and Roses.
Oh, excellent.
So those do exist on those platforms. And I don't know how available the vinyl is.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think The Day Before Wine and Roses is pretty readily available, as is the 3½. I think all of these are, actually. I think they're all pretty readily available.
Nice.
Yeah, I wanted to take a little sidetrack here. You played Mr. Soul. Soraya, have you seen the Laurel Canyon documentary that's on Epix?
Not yet. I recorded it on my DVR, so I haven't seen it yet.
Excellent. It is very, very good. And you and I attended the Laurel Canyon exhibit at the Grammy Museum many years ago, which was cool.
Seems like eons ago, but
I know. It's really good. And they do a little snippet of Buffalo Springfield doing Mr. Soul in there. You're going to love it.
So I wanted to mention, there's a pretty widely circulated video of Buffalo Springfield on a show called The Hollywood Palace, where they were invited on, and I read the backstory of it. They were invited on to play For What It's Worth, but they wanted to play Mr. Soul. And there was a back and forth. And they said, fine, we'll play it. They get into the first chorus, and then they flip the script and they start playing Mr. Soul. I love scenes like that where bands just go, you want me to play this? I'm going to play that. Elvis Costello does one on Saturday Night Live that was pretty epic.
Yeah.
But
and got him banned from SNL, by the way.
Yes, sir. But the artist wins. I'm sorry. The artist is always right.
It's so punk rock.
Ah.
Rock and roll.
Rock and roll!
All right. Let's move on to Bangles.
Whee!
So, if I'm not mistaken, I don't believe that the Bangles ever officially released a live album. I don't think so. I couldn't find anything. Certainly, they had live tracks and live DVD, live performances on DVD, but I don't think there's a full-length live officially released album by the Bangles.
Quick, let's call Debbie Peterson. Let's find out.
Let's call her back. But they did have plenty of live recordings, or some live recordings. Yeah. So my pick for playing a song from a live performance comes from the B-side of the 12-inch for Going Down to Liverpool. There were actually several releases of Going Down to Liverpool, 7 inches and 12 inches. This version was a version that came out in the UK. So it came out a little bit later than the American version, and it had Going Down to Liverpool and Let It Go on side A, and then on the flip side, the B side of the Going Down to Liverpool 12-inch was, I don't know if I want to say it's a medley, but they do Walking Down Your Street and James as basically as one live piece. And it was recorded live by Radio Clyde Mobile 2 at Queen Margaret Union, Glasgow University, March 1st, 1986. And I just really like this version, especially when it kicks into James. We know Walking Down Your Street was co-written by Sue Hoff's producer, David Kahn, and the 3 O'Clock's Louis Gutierrez.
Yes.
And James was written by Vicki Peterson, but Sue sings on it. And there's a cool little breakdown on James when they get to that. So, So actually I get two songs kind of melded into one. So Walking Down Your Street and James live from the Bengals.
Okay, what's up, our new album?
We'll be right back.
So that's a lot of fun.
Ah, so good.
Yeah.
I'll forgive you the extra track.
Sorry. All right. So your turn.
Yeah. So I was sticking with my, I want to hear covers.
Okay.
I want to hear live covers.
Okay.
And the Bengals have one of my absolute all-time favorite covers, and it's only a demo, and it was on Ladies and Gentlemen, the Bengals. It's called Steppin' Out, and it's a cover of a Paul Revere and the Raiders song. Love that song. But I've already talked about it. So I had to pick something else. And I mean, they do, in their repertoire, in their live repertoire, there are a lot of really good live covers. But I picked one that I absolutely love, and I think I still have Debbie Peterson on the brain, because she does lead vocals on this particular cover. So I picked a song from Return to Bangalonia, which is a DVD. Yeah. So that was fair game. It's still live performance. And it was a performance at the House of Blues in Hollywood in September of 2000. And the song I picked is down near the end of the set, second to last song. And it's a cover of The Seeds, Pushing Too Hard, with Debbie Peterson, the amazing Debbie Peterson on lead vocal.
Oh, You guys are totally bitching. Thank you.
Totally.
She said we are totally bitching.
Yeah.
There's nothing else to say. Let me give you the track listing. I'm gonna leave the commentary there. So on this DVD, they perform 18 songs. So it starts out with Hazy Shade of Winter, Live, If She Knew What She Wants, Between the Two, The Rain Song, Manic Monday, Here Right Now, September Girls, Going Down to Liverpool, I Will Take Care of You, Get the Girl in Your Room, Stealing Rosemary, Angels Don't Fall in Love, Hero Takes a Fall, Walk Like an Egyptian, Pushing Too Hard, and Ending with Eternal Flame.
Yes, that's a good DVD. I actually didn't get it when it originally came out in 2007, but I bought it last year, and it's a lot of fun to watch.
It's good?
Yeah, it's good.
I think I've only watched the videos that are posted online. I don't have it in my possession.
Yeah, I think most of them you can find on YouTube, too.
Yeah.
And it's good. And they also, on the DVD, it's got some bonus tracks, too, and it includes some acoustic versions of a couple songs, and those ended up on some releases as well. So there's an acoustic version of Ride the Ride.
Uh-huh.
That's included on the CD single of Tear Off Your Own Head. It's a Doll Revolution, and it's from the same House of Blues session.
Right.
And then also, there's an acoustic version of Eternal Flame that's on the CD single of Something That You Said. And that came out in 2003. So those can also be found in CD format. And there's a couple live songs that were part of the Ladies and Gentlemen, the Bangles compilation. You mentioned that there's the demo version of Stepping Out. There's also live versions of Seven and Seven Is, the love song, and Tell Me. So there's those two live songs that can be found on that as well. But not a whole lot from the Bangles from live recordings.
Officially,
yeah. We found plenty. I mean, plenty were found.
Beth and Jane have found things, but
yeah, exactly.
Not Jeff and Soraya, never.
So, speaking of not having a lot of officially released recordings, we come to the 3 o'clock.
Yeah.
So they had nothing up until recently with a couple Record Store Day releases where they had officially released material. What I wanted to play was something that is not exactly technically the 3 o'clock. It's the Salvation Army. So we had that really, really fun event at the Wilson Park where we met up with the band and we listened to it in the park. That was so much fun, Soraya.
We tried to recreate it, same space, same place, and two of three of the members.
Yes. Yeah.
Which was awesome.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. And this was taken from Live from the Torrents and Beyond. It was a Record Store Day release that they released last year in 2019. Yeah. And the show took place on May 22nd, 1982, at, as we previously mentioned, at Wilson Park. And I'll list the track listing for the album. So side A is She Turns the Flowers, Upside Down, Lucifer Sam, Marjorie Tells Me, With a Cantaloupe Girlfriend, Feel a Whole Lot Better, I Am Your Guru, and they end with Going Home. And I decided I wanted to play With a Cantaloupe Girlfriend. So it was Salvation Army at the time, just before they changed their name to the 3 o'clock. So it's an early version of With a Cantaloupe Girlfriend before the band changed their name. So
right.
This is Salvation Army doing With a Cantaloupe Girlfriend.
Get up here and be fun, people.
No, it's not the circle jerks. How do you expect them to do that?
Thank you. tomorrow in the shadow of your friends. And the secrets you keep are much longer than you have been. In the shadow of your river, castle of your river, castle of your, you'll go everywhere.
Michael, blow your mind. I love at the beginning. I think it's Lewis. Get up here and be fun, people.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's Lewis. Anyway, so that's a fun recording. And you could hear the genesis of what would become With a Cantaloupe Girlfriend that ends up
right.
Baroque Hoedown.
Definitely there, but that early version is, it's good.
Yes.
And then I picked from a different official live recording, which was Live at the Old Waldorf, which came out, also another Burger Records release, came out in 2013. And I picked a cover that's just, this song is so good live, and they do a great version of it. This is Lucifer Sam, cover of a Pink Floyd's Lucifer Sam.
Rome, there are many cats in Rome. I've never been to Rome, but I'm told. And I can't explain it because I've never been there. So it's something I can't explain.
So good.
So, you know, that performance took place only about 9 months after the Salvation Army performance that I just played.
Mm-hmm.
So they were pretty close in time.
You and I picked songs from a really key developmental time in the band's history.
Absolutely.
And oh, man, on Lucifer, Sam, they all are just, wow, they're so good on that one. Love that version. So, Jeff, is the show over? Have they turned on the house lights? You gotta leave now?
Yeah, I think it's about time.
Oh, man. That sucks.
The show's always gotta come to an end.
I hate that. When the lights come on, I hate that part.
I know.
I miss a live show. Yeah. Soon, Jeff, soon.
When it's safe to do so.
And then we got to make up for lost time.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. All right. Well, that was fun.
I hate to say goodbye. I hate to leave the club. I hate it when the lights come on. But, you know, you all got to go somewhere and you can't stay here. So, gente, agarubiar.
Groove on, Paisley people. Was it those girls in my history era?